So hello guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Barbie Chatterjee with you guys back again. Just let me go back. So hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So this is Barbie Chatterjee with you guys back again with another video. So today I'm back with another video where I am going to do a comparison between the Neutrogena Hydro Boost Moisturizer and the Pond Super Lightweight Moisturizer. I guess that's what it's called. Yeah, it's the Pond Super Light Moisturizer. So I recently purchased the Pond Super Light Moisturizer and I already had the Neutrogena Moisturizer. So I have been testing out both these products on my own bare skin, and yeah, I'll be telling you a difference. I'll be giving you the comparison in the video. So if you want to know which one is better and which one you should invest in, then let's get started. But before that, you need to subscribe to my channel, like if you like my video, then again share it with your friends, and also comment down below how did this video help you out, and if you want more such reviews. So yeah, let's get started. So first, let's see how the packaging looks like. So Neutrogena Hydro Boost comes in a packaging somewhat like this, and Pond Super Light Moisturizer comes in a packaging somewhat like this. So Pond comes in its standard packaging, which is this blue and white kind of packaging, and it's just a very standard packaging, and this comes with an outer cardboard box. And let's move it inside. The outer cardboard box also again looks really fancy, and if we dig into it, we have the product right over here. So this is how they look side by side. So of course Neutrogena Hydro Boost looks a little bit luxe. Like if you just keep it on the top of your shelf, it would just really look good. But this has that same I'm sorry. Same standard kind of packaging. So this is like the basic packaging. So if you talk about the packaging here, Neutrogena is taking a point, and again, let's go to the price. So the price point of these products is like totally different. So Neutrogena Hydro Boost is said to be the dupe of the Clinique Moisture Surge Moisturizer, which retails for around, I guess, 2550 for 50 grams of product, and this one retails for 850 rupees for 50 grams of product. Again, now Pond retail for 149 rupees for 73 grams of the product. So here the weight is mentioned, you can just pause and see, and this one retails for only 179 rupees. So which is again a great deal, because you are just paying like 149 rupees. So this is for 850, this is for 150. Like there's a huge price difference. This is more than triple the price of Pond's, and the Clinique is again more than double the price of Neutrogena Hydro Boost. So of course you can see that there is a very good transition. Like if you don't want to splurge so much on the Clinique Moisture Surge, you can definitely go in again with the Neutrogena Hydro Boost. But again, Neutrogena Hydro Boost is also an expensive product, because this retails for 850, and I can understand that 850 might also drill a hole in the pocket of some people, usually teenagers, and yeah, everyone has a different budget. So if you consider that this might come into your budget, like 150, and this is like super affordable, extra cheap, you can just definitely go ahead with this. Okay, so let's go on to the ingredients. So if we go on to the ingredients list, both have almost same ingredients, just they have like slightly different ingredients, you know, one or two are different. And next, if we go on to the claims, so the Pond's doesn't claim anything like extraordinary, but it claims to be an oil-free moisturizer. It's a super light gel for non-sticky glowing skin. It contains hyaluronic acid and vitamin E. So as far the Neutrogena Hydro Boost is concerned, I have already compared the Neutrogena Hydro Boost moisturizer with the Plum green tea face moisturizer. It's also a gel moisturizer. So if you want to check out that video, you can just go down in the description box below, or you can just find it out in my channel. So yeah, while talking about the Neutrogena Hydro Boost Moisturizer, this claims to continuously boost skin's water retention ability and effectively lock in abundant hydration deep within your skin without the delay. So this is probably, you know, this claims to be a 48 hour moisturizing lotion or a face moisturizer, but who needs a moisturizer 48 hours? Because I definitely wash my face two times in a day, once in the morning and once in the night, so I'll definitely reapply that. So I just don't like, I don't need a 48 hour moisturizing thing. So if it's a 24 hour moisturizing thing, also it's good for me. So this moisturizer is actually my favorite moisturizer. I loved it so freaking much, but you know, of course the price is too high, so using it regularly, and you know, this is my second tub, so if it gets over, then you have to spend again 850 rupees over this, which is not a great which is not a small amount. So it again drills a hole in your pocket. So let's come to the texture of the moisturizer. So the texture of the moisturizer is somewhat very gel like consistency. You can see if I hold it like this, it's coming, it's going to fall down, and you can see I'm almost done with this moisturizer. It's almost gonna get over. And it smells heavenly. It just smells heavenly. Then next, coming to the Pond's Super Light Gel Moisturizer. It's not as watery as this. This is a little bit more natural blue in color. And this is a more whitish gel-like blue in color, as you can see. I'll be inserting a demo video for you guys in between, where I'm gonna apply the Neutrogena Hydro Boost Moisturizer and on one side and a Pond's Moisturizer on one side, so you can just see the application. So over here, the Pond's Moisturizer smells a little bit different. It smells like the general Pond's Moisturizer you get normally. So it smells somewhat like that, and this one has a different kind of smell. It just has a very soothing and calming smell. Both are really soothing for your skin. So whenever I apply the Neutrogena Hydro Boost Moisturizer on my skin, as you can see on the video, I'll be inserting it in between. So whenever I apply that, my skin just feels like primed up. Like, it's supremely prime. Like, you know, it doesn't cover up my pores, but it just makes my skin feel so baby soft to touch. And the same thing is done by the Pond's Moisturizer, which is again great because the price point is literally like so high, like so different. So Pond's Moisturizer also again does the same thing for my skin. That's why I am like loving these super like light gel like moisturizers by Neutrogena and Pond's. So if I would give my opinion that which moisturizers should you particularly buy, then I would definitely suggest the Pond's Moisturizer. It does hydrate my skin. It again does make my skin like smooth and soft. It doesn't blur out your pores definitely, but this will be a very good pre-makeup based moisturizer. And if you want to spend 850 bucks on the Neutrogena Moisturizer, go ahead. It's also again a great moisturizer, but I would definitely recommend you to get the Pond's gel super light gel moisturizer, because it's again very affordable, very lightweight in formula, and you're getting more the like more quantity for the price you are paying as compared to the Neutrogena one. So if I repurchase, I'm gonna repurchase the Pond's one, and I'm not gonna repurchase the Neutrogena anymore, because of course it's pricier and the quantity is less, and like, why not? If I get the same product in a lesser price and in more quantity, then why not? Should I go for this moisturizer? So I'll definitely recommend you buying the Pond's Super Light Wet Gel Moisturizer. And yeah, that was it for today's video. Thank you for watching, and I hope this video was helpful for you guys. And yeah, please subscribe and like my channel, and also comment down below if you want more such reviews. Bye bye, take care.